postgraduates, was it Perez and Marsteller that wrestled in the Pittsburgh wrestling card?
Yes.
They're your postgrads.
Yeah, well, they're the RTC guys.
Okay.
Yeah,
sorry.
Them, Dean Heil, and
RTC
Perez.
Guys,
yeah.
I'm saying it wrong.
Yeah, they're in the RTC program.
Building that side of it, an RTC.
It was already there. It was already there when I got there.
They weren't, though.
They weren't. So we put those guys in there. Looking at a small guy, you know, we're looking at a little guy now, but they're there, they train. This year was crazy with COVID. They couldn't train regularly because RTC couldn't really operate there this year. Now we're back into a normal year, and so hopefully the RTC is rocking and rolling, and, you know, we're running.
Chances, he looked amazing.
Yeah, amazing, and, you know, I say his training wasn't where it should have been, you know what I mean? He was at Lehigh, now he's commuting to get to us and stuff. But now I think he's going to be normalized on a schedule. And, yeah, that guy's got – he's got potential, that's for sure.
You told a story about Quentin today. You recruited him out of Texas.
Yeah.
Did a lot of stuff wrong, 5-25.
Yeah.
Then all of a sudden he turns around, he's a top 10 guy. Season gets canceled because of COVID.
Yeah, it was crazy.
But he's right there. Upside. I guess the long and the short of it is Chance Marsteller had an upside after high school.
Yeah.
You know, it was, you know, not a lot. He didn't have a ton of room for improvement because he was great.
He was good, yeah.
He was great already. But Perez is the opposite end of that spectrum.
Yeah.
How do you find those guys?
Well, I mean, Perez was luck, literally luck, because when I'd taken the job, I went through the NHSCA's placements, and I was like, and I think he placed his sophomore year. And then when I'm like, is this guy committed? You know, and I just start calling.
You were mass recruiting.
I was mass recruiting when I got there and calling and looking at guys. I'd see a guy, spend 5-10 minutes. Yeah, he's not bad. Let's call him. You know, and that's what it was, because there was no team originally when I got there. We had a team, but we didn't have the depth for training. I knew it was going to be, you know, 3 years of getting it there where we could finally do something. I didn't know we'd win a SoCon in 3 years. You know, I always say what it would have been easier is probably if Campbell was a brand new program, because there was a lot of history of not a lot of success. Great people came through there. I'm friends with a lot of those alumni. Great people came through there, but there wasn't top 20 impact. You know what I mean? And if it would have been a brand new program, it'd probably been easier. You know, so we fought through some dismal history, maybe not competitive history, and then it started going. You know,
getting your first All-American. You know, you haven't done that at Navy yet. Another year.
Yeah,
but you got your first All-American with Kreiser.
Yeah,
was that as hard as you thought it was going to be?
No, not really. Because I knew Nathan had it. He had to pick the right weight class. He was at 33. He had to pick it. I didn't force him to 25. And I didn't even talk about it because we had been there before. I knew it. That guy's going to have to come in. Because you know what I find? If you pick a weight for a guy, you can have a conversation. But if you pick the weight, it's not going to work. That guy's got to come in and finally say, this is the weight. Came in and said this was the weight. Talked about it. You got to be here at this many months. We'll wrestle you this many duels. You'll have this many weigh-ins. You know, we didn't wrestle them all year, and it worked.